morning of Santiago Day is clouded by grey and white, as if set in cotton. Everyone has gone to church. The sparrows and Platero and I have remained in the garden. Sparrows, under the round clouds, which at times rain a few drops, how they come and go in the climbing vines, how they shrill, how they peck at each other's bills. One lights on above, takes flight and leaves it quivering. Another drinks a bit of sky from the little pool on the well curb. Another has leaped up to the roof from the olive tree, whose almost dry flowers the grey day brightens in contrast. Blessed birds, with no fixed holy days, free in the monotony of the innate, of the real. Bells mean nothing to them unless it be a vague joyousness. Well content with no fatal obligations, with no Olympus to enrapture, nor Avernus to terrify them, with no morality but their own, nor any god but the blue. They are my brothers, my sweet brothers. They travel without money and without luggage. They leave a house when the fancy strikes them. They know where to find a brook. They divine a fern. And they need but to open their wings to gain happiness. They know nothing of Mondays and Saturdays. They bath anywhere, anytime. They love nameless love, the universal loved one. And when people, poor wretched people, go to church on Sundays, locking their doors behind them, they, in a glad example of rightless love, suddenly come with a fresh and jovial shrilling to the gardens of the closed house in which some poet, whom they know well, and a tender small donkey. Will you let me join our names, Platero? Watch them with fraternal love.